Can you tell me, yeah, the idea?
Can I, sir?
Yes.
So in chapter three, we are going to learn about a lot of kinds of phrases, like adjective phrase, noun phrase, and also the function of it. That, like that, sir.
Okay. Any more comment?
Can I, sir?
Yes, Ismail.
So I think in chapter three, we are going to talk about the definition of praise and kind of praises, sir. I think that's all.
Okay. Who's next?
Octa.
Selfie, yeah, selfie Octa.
Yeah. Okay. In chapter three, same like Anita and Ma'il said, in chapter three, we're gonna talk about the phrase, about the definitions, about the functions, and also the structures. I think that's all.
All right. Yeah. Who wants to say something different?
Rita, probably. Sir.
Rita Haryati, go ahead.
Okay. In chapter three, we will learn about the definition of praise, the kind of praise, and also the formula of each kind of praises, sir.
Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Yes.
Can I, sir?
Yeah, Yogi.
So, in my opinion, we learn in this chapter is first is we describe what is meant by phrase. Second is we understand and distinguish different kinds of phrase. The third is we write and use a phrase in a sentence, sir.
Okay, good. Thank you. Enough? Oh, maybe yes. Daddy Kurniawan. Oh no, Daddy is it? Kenapa ada Daddy Kurniawan ini? Oh, okay. Live ya, yeah. Recorded. Yeah. Yes, who's next?
Can I, sir?
Yes, sir. Can I?
Yeah, answer? Ellen. Okay, Ellen. Ellen.
Okay. First of all, I'm sorry, sir. It's quite noisy here. So in the chapter three, what we are gonna learn is about phrase. So the definition of phrase, the kind of phrases. So we will distinguish and learn how to membedakan, distinguish kind of phrases. And also we are gonna learn about how to make phrases, the formula. Yeah, I think that's all.
Okay, just now you said it was busy in your place. Where are you now?
I'm in my hometown, sir.
Where is it?
In Lampung. Lampung.
In Lampung. Tengah, which part of Lampung?
Lampung Tengah.
Lampung. Is it in metro?
Terbanggi.
Oh, Terbanggi. Iya, Terbanggi. Terbanggi. I think Terbanggi. Terbanggi is Menggala, ya, yeah, right? How far is it from Menggala?
It's quite far, sir. From my home to Menggala, it's around 1.5 hour.
Oh, yeah. Terbanggi besar, right? Yeah. Are there many ayam kampung there?
Sorry, sir?
I used to eat ayam kampung, you know, Inter Bangi besar ya. I still remember during our trip previous goals. Alright, thank you. Who's next? Ada lagi? I give you one more or two more.
Can participant. Tiara.
Tiara. Alright.
In the chapter 3, we can learn about prayers and the definition of prayers, the type of prayers such as like non-prayers, verb prayers, adverb prayers, adjective prayers, prepositional prayers, and we also learn about the function of prayers and the structure of prayers in the sentence. I think that's also. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Where are you now, Tiara Febrianti?
In my home, sir. Kepahyang Bengkulu.
In Palembang.
Kepahyang Bengkulu, sir.
In Pahyang. Kepahyang.
Yeah.
You go to Kepahyang from Linggau or from Pagaralam?
Yes, from Linggau, sir.
From Linggau. Why not from Pagaralam and then Empat Lawang and then Padang Tepung and then Kepahyang? Texas, yeah.
Sorry, sir.
Why don't you take Pagaralam and then Pendopo and then what is it? Padang Tepung, yeah. And then Kepahyang.
Maybe. Jaraknya lebih jauh, sir.
Much further, yeah.
Yes, of course.
Oh, yeah. From Palembang, you go to Lubulingga by train, right?
Yeah.
And then from Lubulingga, yeah, you pass Curug and then Kepahyang, right?
Right.
Okay. If you go to Kepahyang, I have a friend whose name is Supriyadi in SMA Muhammadiyah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. How about Curug? Yeah, still popular?
Of course, sir.
Still popular?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, Tiara. Yeah, next, satu lagi, one more.
Ibu Jaga,
bye, sir.
Adi, sir.
Oke, Puja.
Chapter, I think we will learn about the definition of phrase and also the structure of phrase. Which one is the head? Which one is the complement? And then we will learn of kind of phrases that are adjective phrase, noun phrase, verb phrase, adverb phrase and prepositional phrase, and also we learn how to distinguish them. I think that's all.
Okay, thank you everybody. Yeah, yes, yeah. First, you must be able to identify whether it is a phrase or not. Words. Yeah, of course. If you say that it is a group of related words, yeah, it means at least there are two words. Yeah, generally. Yeah, if it is only one word, it is not a phrase. Yeah, grammatically. Okay, grammatically, remember. Okay, and then you have to be able to identify, oh, this is adjective phrase, this is adverb phrase, this is prepositional phrase, this is verb phrase, this is noun phrase, etc., etc., right? So you know different kinds of phrases. And then you have to be able to understand how to make a noun phrase, how to make prepositional phrase, what is it? Okay. Yeah. Okay, sir. I have already understood how to make each kind of phrases. Okay. And then you have to be able to identify the head. Every phrase has a head. Noun phrase, the head of noun phrase is noun. Hello, Mary. How are you, Mary? Show your face. Are you still in Bangka?
Yeah.
Connection again. Mary, show your face. This is your third time, third meeting. Yeah, first meeting, I think. Yeah, you missed two meetings. You have already missed two meetings. Mary, can you hear me? Mary, can you hear me?
Yeah. Hello, sir.
You missed two meetings. This is the third meeting. How comes you missed two meetings?
Yes, a week ago I had a bad connection, sir.
But you didn't give me any message, you know?
Yes, because I have that connection and it's hard for me to join the Zoom meeting.
Sorry, what is it? You didn't give me message before that you had bad connection in WhatsApp. No news. Yeah, so you have been considered absent. Yeah. Make sure no from class. Yeah. Ya, siapa yang mau screenshot tadi? Ya, go ahead, silakan. Alright, ya. So you know types of phrases. You know the formula how to make how to form each type of phrase, right? Okay. And then you know the head. Yeah, of course. If it is a noun phrase, the head must be noun. If it is adjective phrase, if it is verb phrase, the head must be adjective. If it is a verb phrase, the head must be verb. Yeah. If the head is, if it is a prepositional phrase, the head must be preposition. Okay. Right. Okay, I think you have read, yeah. You have read how to form. You have read what is it? The book or the file? Yeah, in the file or in the book, you can see how to form noun phrase, right? Mm-hmm. Make sure, yeah. Noun phrase. It can be more than one modifiers. Noun phrase. Jadi noun phrase itu bisa jadi yang menerangkannya itu lebih dari satu. Yeah. If you look at the book, yeah, a lady, yeah, you have only a young lady, you have two modifiers. A beautiful young lady, you have three modifiers. Yeah, a very beautiful young lady, you have four modifiers. Ya, yeah. Five word noun phrase, makanya disebut five word noun phrase, two word noun phrase, three word noun phrase. Yeah. If it is a five word noun phrase, it means there are four modifiers appear. Okay. How about the function? Yeah, the function the same. Since it is noun, yeah, the function as a noun. In a sentence, yeah. The function as a noun, yeah, you know function of noun. It can be as a subject. It can be as an object. Yeah. So, grammatical category, noun, phrase. Grammatical function, it can be as a subject. It can be as an object. That is. Okay. Clear, right? Okay. And then you have adjectives. You know the formula how to form adjective phrase, yeah? You have adjective and then preceded by adverb. Yeah, there are only two. Hanya dua dia ya, hanya ya adverb kemudian adjective. Yeah, so the head is adjective. Yeah. Very quickly, extremely happy. And then also you have verb phrase. Yeah, you have verb. Yeah, grammatically, you have, if you have only one word, for example, I drink coffee every day. Yeah, drink. Yeah, it's not, drink is not phrase grammatically, but syntactically it is a phrase. Secara syntax dia disebut phrase, tapi secara grammar dia bukan phrase. If you refer to the definition of a phrase, yeah, is a group of related words. Yeah. Bagaimana membentuknya I drink coffee? Bagaimana supaya drink ini menjadi phrase? Misalnya, oh, I will drink coffee. Yeah. I have been drinking. Okay. I have drunk. Okay. Tapi kalau I drank saja, itu bukan phrase. Secara grammar. Tapi kalau secara syntax, sudah phrase dia. Yeah. If you talk about syntax, any single word can be practically. Secara syntax, dia itu phrase. Yeah. Tapi secara grammar dia satu kata. Misalnya, he is my friend. He is a phrase syntactically. Tapi grammatically dia bukan. Jadi word saja dia. He. Tapi the boy itu phrase and grammatically phrase juga. Ya, bedakan itu secara sinteks bisa saja satu kata itu phrase. Subject phrase. Object phrase. Oke, ada. Oke, itu verb phrase. Jadi syaratnya apa? Ada kata bantu. Baru dia dikatakan frasa. Kalau Suhang sendirian, ya, dewean, maka dia disebut kata tunggal saja, bukan frasa. Ya. You know kata bantu, helping verbs, you know ya? Yeah. Who is not familiar with helping verbs? Hello? Who still doesn't understand helping verbs or modals or auxiliaries? Raise your hand. Oh, saya tidak tahu apa itu helping verb. Saya tidak tahu itu modal. Saya tidak tahu auxiliary. Susah kamu. Susah omong lah. Susah omong lah. Yang segitu-gitu saja. Belum mengerti susah lah. Tidak ada masalah lagi, no auxiliaries, modals, okay. Nanti kalau saya tanya satu-satu ada saja, mungkin pelongo, yakin saya. Apa sih beda modals dengan auxiliaries? Masih pelongo. Saingan Mr. Dick gitu. Ya. Yeah. Oke. Okay. yakin ya, tapi tidak usah lah ya, nanti dia malu, dia pelongo-pelongo ya. Apa beda what is it, auxiliaries dengan to be misalnya kan? Masih pelongo-pelongo. Oke. Okay. Ya, memang ya, kalau sudah sering pelongo-pelongo, ya memang pimpinan kita sering pelongo-pelongo. Ya, akibatnya muridnya juga pelongo-pelongo. Ya. Oke. Okay. Nah, oke, okay, ya. Kemudian and then adverb phrase. Ya, pasti ada adverb. Kalau tidak ada adverb, tidak mungkin lah. Okay. Modified by what? By adverb, adverb itself. Jadi adverb diterangkan oleh adverb. Okay. Okay. Jadilah adverb phrase. Okay. And then prepositional phrase. Nah, do you still remember how many prepositions are there in English? Do you still remember how many prepositions there are in English?
Dua.
Azahra dua katanya. Ya, oke. Okay. Very good, very fine. Not so good, cari yang lain. Yes. Do you remember how many prepositions there are in English?
45, sir.
Sorry?
45, sir.
Yeah, there are 45 prepositions in English. Yeah. Yeah, maybe Azahra Salwa will say something different. Yeah. What do you what you mean by there are two? Can you mention?
Fungsinya, sir. Salah, sir. Maksudnya fungsinya.
Fungsinya. The function of preposition, ya? Yeah?
Iya, yeah, sir.
What they are?
Yang pertama itu adverb, yaitu fungsi prepositional phrase untuk menjelaskan verb. Yang kedua itu adjective, yaitu prepositional phrase yang menjelaskan noun.
Oke. Okay. You know preposition, ya? Yeah? Prepositions followed by noun. Yeah. If you have noun or pronoun, yeah, it will become a prepositional phrase. Yeah. And the other one is preposition that is linked with adjective verb. Kan ada kata depan, tapi dia meleng, ya, attach with adjectives. Ya, good at, ya, look for, agree with, ya, fond of, ya, familiar with, ya, okay. Prepositions, attach with ya atau or adjective preposition verb attached with preposition ya. Look for, listen to, look at, okay. Made in, made from. Okay. Prepositional phrase, usually the one with noun or noun phrase. Ya. Preposition yang berdiri sendiri. Berdiri sendiri. It stands alone. Not together with adjective or verb. Different, ya. I am responsible for syntax class. Responsible for. But for here, related with responsible, okay? Yeah, responsible attached with for. It cannot stand alone. Dia harus berkaitan tuh. I want to give this book for my friend. For here, for my friend is prepositional phrase. Prepositional phrase. So you have to distinguish between prepositional phrase, preposition with nouns, yeah, to form phrase, and then preposition attached with adjective or verbs. You bedakan itu. Bisa tak membedakan? I am good at reading. Yeah. At here, preposition bukan diikuti reading karena preposition karena good at tadi memang dia sudah bergandengan ya one group. Okay. Okay. I live at Plaju. At here is yeah, it stands alone. Yeah, is free. Berdiri sendiri. At I live bukan live itu karena at bukan atau at itu karena live bukan. Menunjukkan tempat. Makanya itu di basic sudah ada dia menunjukkan tempat. Time. Yeah. Preposition shows time, maybe place, at 9 o'clock, at Plaju. Beda dengan I'm going to look at my friend. Different. Different. At di situ ada hubungan dengan look. Okay, nah itu. So if you have preposition, it is followed by noun or pronoun, maka terbentuklah prepositional phrase. Okay? Nah, what is the function of prepositional phrase? Fungsinya apa itu?
There are three.
Yes, Fahroza.
Ada tiga, sir. Prepositional phrase. And then post modifier of an adjective and an adverbial.
Okay. If noun, you know, yeah, same function in a sentence. Adjective phrase also. If you understand adjective, the function of adjective, yeah, I think it is the same, yeah. It is, you, there have, yeah, was it? They have the same function, yeah, with the adjective, single adjective or adjective phrase as a modifier. Okay. And then you have the phrase. Yeah, the phrase. If you understand the function of verb, yeah, automatically you understand the function of the phrase. You still remember what the function of verb is?
Predicate.
As a?
Predicate.
As a predicate, yeah. As a predicator, as a core, yeah, the key point of a sentence or of a clause, as the core, the center of a clause. Predicator, yeah? And then you prepositional phrase. The function of prepositional phrase, yeah, it can be as a complement or as a modifier. Complement, yeah, complement, and maybe as an adverb, maybe. Adverb of time, maybe. Maybe adverb of place. That is prepositional phrase. As a modifier. Yeah. Can you give me example of prepositional phrase as a modifier? Can you give me an example of prepositional phrase as a modifier? Hello? Can you give me
an example?
Yes.
A beautiful girl with an umbrella.
Yeah, Faroza, can you read again?
A beautiful girl with an umbrella.
A beautiful girl with
an umbrella.
Which one is a prepositional phrase?
With an umbrella.
What is the function of a prepositional phrase here?
First modifier of noun.
First modifier of a noun. Okay. Any other example?
Can I, sir?
Yes. Arya Muhaimin.
Yes, sir. With blue eyes as a post modifier from the noun cat.
Okay, a cat with blue eyes. Okay, thank you. Good. Next. Okay, you know noun phrase, you know adjective phrase, you know prepositional phrase, you know phrase. Okay. Among these phrases, which one is the most complex one? Atau, yeah. The possible, ya, ada kemungkinan ya. Ah, kemungkinan susah Pak buat yang ini. Perasaan ini ha, itu atau it is possible that I don't understand how to identify this phrase ha. Which one, which phrase is possibly a little bit confusing.
Can I, sir?
Yeah.
If I'm personally, I'm still confused with the formula of to infinitive phrases.
Oh, infinitive phrase.
Yes.
Oh, Anita Nurhaliza, yeah. Anita Nurhaliza. Infinitive phrase. Oh yeah, yeah. Anybody among you who wants to describe what is meant by infinitive phrase? Okay, let me ask you first. Generally, what is the function of infinitive phrase atau infinitive?
As noun.
As a noun. Yes, as a noun. Yeah. As a noun. When you talk about gerund and infinitive, yeah, I'm not sure who taught you grammar. Yeah, if I were to taught you grammar, or if I had been a grammar teacher for you, yeah, you should have understood. Nah, ini apa? Was it, if I had been your grammar teacher, you should have been understood. Kalimat pengandaian ketiga itu. Atau, if I had been your grammar teacher, you must have been understood. You must have understood. Yeah. You must have understood. Atau, you must have been familiar with the function of infinitive. Infinitive. Do you still remember? Okay. Once, I think I taught you before. Yeah? I love bananas. I love kue bolu. I love my friend. I love my university. I love chicken. Chicken, noun. Bananas, noun. University, noun. My friend, noun. I love reading. Ya, sarupa. Noun also. Reading. Ya, jaran. I love to learn Arabic. I love to learn Arabic. What the same? Function to learn. Ya, noun kalau gitu. Sama kan? If you substitute. Yeah. I love bananas. I love reading. I love my friend. I love my university. I love to study Arabic. I love to sleep. Relax, ya sama dong fungsinya kalau begitu sebagai noun dia. Tapi grammatically different. To relax, to infinitive, itulah yang disebut infinitive phrase. Yeah. Mau dipanjangkan lagi, to relax at home. Nah, sudah lengkap lagi kan. Nah. To study Arabic. I love studying Arabic. I love to study Arabic. Sama. Namanya beda. Arabic ajaran. I love to study Arabic is to infinitive phrase. Ajaran phrase. Itu yang disebut to infinitive. As an object. Bisa Pak sebagai subjek? Ya bisa lah. Yeah, bisa, why not? Pempek is my favorite food. Pempek. Tennis table is my favorite sport. Tennis table. Okay. Cooking is my hobby. Wah, Jaren. Cooking is my hobby. Sama kan? Pempek is my hobby. Cooking is my hobby. Jaren berarti cooking tadi. To cook traditional food is my hobby. Sama. To cook. Cooking traditional food is my hobby. To cook traditional food is my hobby. Hanya beda dikit. Dikit-dikit pengertiannya. Nah, bedanya kalau cooking itu mungkin kebiasaan. Is more usual, more common. Okay? Nah, itulah yang disebut apa tadi Anita Nurhaliza, ya. Infinitive phrase as a noun, okay. Jadi sama. I want bananas. Oh, bananas is object. I want to cook rice. Oh, to cook rice ya object. Grammatical category to infinitive phrase. Yeah. I want fried rice. Fried rice noun phrase. Yeah. Sebagai as function object. Sama kan? Object of verb want. I want fried rice. What do you want? Oh, I want fried rice. Oh, fried rice. Yes. Oh, fried rice in object. What do you want? I want to cook traditional food. Oh, traditional food. To cook traditional food. Oh, object. Yeah. Object of apa? Object of want. Tidak. Pak, I want to cook traditional food. Traditional food kan objek dari cook. Betul. Jadi sup lagi dia. Kalau you buat lingkaran. Lingkaran objek penuh. Lingkaran. Ya, what is it? Lingkaran semestanya apa? To cook traditional food. Nanti. Ada subset lagi. Lingkaran di dalamnya lagi apa? Ya, grup. Ya, ada lagi grupnya apa? Traditional food. Tapi lingkaran besarnya apa? To cook traditional food. Noun phrase. Noun phrase. Dalam bentuk grammarnya apa? To infinitive phrase. Ya. Noun phrase. Di dalam cook traditional food. Ya. Nanti ada traditional food. Itu noun phrase lagi kan? Objek dari apa? Objek dari to cook. Objek dari cook. Jadi sup. Kecil lagi. Bagian kecilnya lagi. Cobalah kamu gambar. Ya. Coba gambar. Try to draw a picture. How it looks like. Buat gambar. Lingkungan ini apa? Himpunan besarnya to cook traditional food. And then himpunan kecilnya adalah what is traditional food? Yeah. Coba, show me your picture, please. I give you time, 5 minutes. Can you draw a picture of the set? Yeah, himpunannya bagaimana? Ya, belajar teori himpunan ya. Saya dapat A nilai teori himpunan nih dulu. Ya, minor saya matematik. Wah, Pak, saya tidak belajar nih. Oh, pasti belajar di SMA. Oh, saya IPS, Pak. Enggak ada IPS, enggak ada IPA soal himpunan ini. Mary, Selfie, Khairun Nisa, ya, show your face. Yang mana yang lain-lain ini. Hari ini di, you are recorded, you know, you are recorded. Everybody is recorded today, ya, by Pak Hariswan. Resi Gustiani, Hesti Agustianti, where are you? Where are you? Yeah, I'm sorry, you are recorded. Yeah. Habis kuota apa? Minta si Makarim ya. Yeah.
Enggak, sir.
Jackie, your face please. Ya, yeah. Who is ready? Who is ready? Show me your picture. Alimatus Sadia, your picture please. Ah, hiya, ni hao ma. Ni hao ma, Rafli. Ni hao ma. Ya, mana gambarnya? Himpunan kamu bagaimana bunyi nampaknya? Tidak ada yang siap? Nobody is ready yet? Aulia Sari? Rita, okay, show me.
Okay, please, sir.
Okay. Photo is go ahead.
Loading. Can you see the picture, sir?
No. No, not yet.
Bentar ya, sir. Fotonya loading, sir.
Anybody can do it, yeah. Anybody can do it.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Can you see my screen, sir?
No, thank you. No, not yet.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Siapa lagi yang siap duluan? Ada lagi? Oh, Rita Haryati. Not yet. No, not yet.
Salah ya, sir.
Apa tadi bunyinya tadi? Kasih contoh tadi apa? What is it?
To cook traditional food, sir.
Ya, yeah. To apa?
To cook, sir.
Cook. To cook, ya. Yeah.
Cook.
To cook traditional food, ya. Yeah. To cook traditional food. Tidak bisa melihat saya. Ya, coba yang lain, yang lain. Yang who is prepared now? Who has already prepared it? Who is ready for to food, traditional food? How it looks like? How the set looks like? Bagaimana himpunannya? Fatia, yeah, Fatia, you want to share your...
Sorry, sir, tadi punya Rita gambarnya belum kelihatan ya di slide-nya?
Iya. Yeah. Betul, belum.
Bisa diulang nggak, Zar?
Boleh.
Okay. Sudah kelihatan belum, Zar?
Hold on, sebentar. Hold on. Ike to cook traditional food. Yeah. Okay, that's great. Yeah. Everybody can see this. So the whole set, is to cook traditional food. And then, the subset is a traditional food. Yeah. Dia dalam lingkaran ya. Jadi traditional food itu dalam lingkaran. Ya. Lingkaran besarnya, himpunan besarnya adalah to cook traditional food. Kemudian traditional food ini, food ini bisa dihitung atau tidak? Kalau bisa dihitung ya traditional food, right, okay, correct ya. If it is uncountable, no a. Yeah. Make sure, yeah. So please check. Please check, yeah.
Okay, sir.
So the picture is like this, right? Yeah. Jadi dia di dalam lingkaran dia, dalam lingkaran himpunan besarnya. Nah, kesemuanya ini disebut objek. Yeah. Nanti the function is to cook traditional food is an object. Grammatical kategori ya infinitive phrase, noun phrase. Grammatical kategori infinitive phrase. Function as an object. Ya. Karena kalau kita substitute I want a book. Yeah, a book is object. Yeah. I want a pempek. Pempek is an object. Yeah. I want money. Money is object, noun. Yeah. Kalau dia noun, ya ini juga noun. Yeah. Noun phrase. Yeah. Grammarnya apa? To infinitive phrase. That is, yeah. Okay, thank you. Now back to apa? Our discussion. Yes. Among these phrases, noun phrase, adjective phrase, adverb phrase, prepositional phrase. What is it? Yeah. What is the most complex one to write? Atau what is the most complicated one? To make. Or to identify, for example.
Noun phrase.
Noun phrase.
Noun phrase.
Noun phrase. Why? Why is it complicated? Jadi yang di antara frasa-frasa ini yang manalah kira-kira sulit membuatnya atau membedakannya? Ya, atau ya kemungkinan macam-macam caranya itu. Ya. Do you have any idea why it is considered a little bit complicated?
It's non-phrase because non-phrase can have more than one adjective.
Oh, because of that, yeah? Okay, yeah. More than one adjective, it can be, yes. Mm-hmm. For example?
For example, a beautiful young lady. We have to know the order to write whether it's beautiful first or young first.
Okay, yes, great. Yeah, sorry, I need to eat some food, I have been teaching since 8:00 this morning. Teaching tulan saya ni bukan main-main. Yeah. Teaching not only sitting but talking, yeah. Asking question and answers. Minum saja baru setengah gelas. I am in Indralaya now, you know. Not at home. Yeah. Kata kamu bilang di rumah santai-santai. No. I am in Indralaya now. Yes. Oh, jadi karena kata noun phrase itu bisa jadi apa? Diterangkan oleh beberapa kata sifat. Okay. Any more comment?
Uja, sir. Because noun phrase can noun phrase. Itu a noun phrase with pre modifier and post modifier. Also, phrase can be like a progressive and some like a passive. Progressive and perfect or passive as a modifier. For example, like the singing bird, an organized party, some kind of like that.
Any more comment? Do you agree, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Do you want something to eat? Do you want something to eat? Something to eat. Noun phrase, yeah? Do you want something to eat? Himpunan besarnya apa?
Something to eat.
Something to eat. Himpunan kecilnya apa?
To eat.
Nah, begitu caranya tuh. Easy actually, you know. As long as you think. Easy actually. Nama sudah tahu. Tinggal lagi dipakai logika. Oh iya ya. Yeah, if you want something to eat, come here. Go to Indra Raya to Prodino. Yes, jadi noun phrase is a complex one sometimes, you know, because complex. It is simple when it is modified by only pre-modifier, a single modifier, a lady, yeah, very simple. You have only one modifier and pre-modifier, a lady. Mudah apa itu? Itu yang dikatakan simple itu. Oh, a young lady. Mulai sedikit ya. A very beautiful young lady. Mulai lagi, sedikit tambah lagi. Yeah. A very beautiful religious young lady, nambah lagi. Masih juga pre-modifier dia. A very beautiful religious young lady in our classroom. In our classroom. Post-modifier. Prepositional phrase. As a post-modifier. Mulai sebelah kiri nerangkan, sebelah kanan nerangkan. Mulai kompleks ya. Kompleks. Namanya apa? Ya, prepositional phrase kan. As a modifier. Post modifier. A very beautiful religious young lady who is now studying syntax in Indra Raya. Who is now studying syntax in Indra Raya? Modifier. Oh, berarti adjective clause bisa post modify. Yes, because adjective function as a noun. So adjective clause, grammatical category, adjective clause function as a modifier to modify lady. So the whole, yeah, the whole, what is it? The whole, the whole set, yeah, the whole set, a very religious young lady who is studying syntax in Indra Raya. Bagaimanakah bentuk himpunannya? Nah. Yo. Atau saya buat singkat saja. Coba. Kita ambil singkat sedikit saja. A young lady in the classroom. Ayo. A young lady in the classroom. Buat himpunan bagaimana? Himpunannya bagaimana? Yang cepat dapat poin 2 langsung. Yusnia Azhar, make sure you have to be You have to be diligent, right? Make sure you have to be diligent.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Do you have friend with you?
Si Gustiana, sir.
Si Gustiana. Is he here? Is he here? Hesti Agustianti, no? No, eh?
See. Not yet, sir.
Not yet, hanya. Yuk tahu kopi nggak toh? Jangan malas.
Pretty inform her, sir, but.
Siapa yang sudah? Apa pertanyaan tadi itu? Apa namanya? Apa tadi?
Young lady in the classroom.
Young lady in the classroom. Ah, ya. Saya tidak bisa buat ini ya. Di laptop saya ini. Kalau laptop yang kemarin itu bisa saya buat sintaks, buku sintaks ini bisa. Tidak bisa, saya tidak bisa, tidak ada drawing-drawingnya. Gimana saya ini sini? Insert apa ini? Insert. Kamu bisa tak buat ini apa? Buat lingkaran di sini, bisa tak buat lingkaran? Pakai apa sini? Lingkar gambar lingkaran.
Seperti ini
Buat lingkaran tak bisa. Mana? Pakai apa ini? Klip ini?
Itu sampingnya,
sir. Ini, shape ini. Oh, terus?
Klip yang mau dipakai.
Oh, ini?
Ya.
Terus mana? Oh. Nah, tapi hilang itu tadi.
Nanti ini geser.
Yang mana?
Ini
serius
terkeluar. Ini. Biru ini ya. Pas di tengah-tengah ini serius. Nah, udah. Ini tulisannya nanti serius. Mau ditaruh di dalam. Control all.
All tuh.
Control ini.
Coba. Bisa ada ini.
Hurufnya hitam.
Enggak, bentar. Nah, terus yang ini mau di ini kan. Di dalam kurung ini nih. Ini. Gimana caranya ini yang dalam kurungnya? Buat kurung lagi dalam.
Ini Pak.
Mau di itu Pak. Tapi di bundar ini yang ini.
Habis baterai.
Mah. Cepat-cepat ini. Nah, cucukkan sih. Buat pulak lagi kayak itu. Enggak bisa.
Buat ini.
Iya, buat pulak kayak itu. Yang ready itu baik sebenarnya.
Bisa. Terus di copy bisa nih, saya copy. Saya taruh bisa di sini. Control.
Sebenarnya kayak gini. Ini bentuknya. Ini sini. Ini. Terus tuh. Yang ini ke sini. Ini ke yang. Terus. Yang ini classroom-nya sini. Kayak yang gitu harusnya. Nah, jadi ini buang lagi. Nah, ini buang gitu. Ya, boleh. Jadi tiga. Coba kalau ada kawannya.
Nah, gitu. Gabung tuh. Aduh, kebanyakan lagi. Gak keluar. Yang kecilnya.
Kedinya di tengah-tengah tuh.
Ini
aku kira buat dulu itu ya, baru kita ini edit ini tulisan aku kira. Nah, satu lagi ini sini. Berarti ngapa editnya sih ini? Gimana ngeditnya ini?
Buat tulisannya tinggal
oh, ini besar ini. Oh, bisa ya. Nah. Ini ya segini. Ini kalau ya betul. Yang ini. Tinggal lagi besar kan. Ininya. Ini dikecilkan, Mbak, ya, sebenarnya. Ini juga. Kita share. Sudah dapat? Have you got it? Not
yes,
yet.
Sir. Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Show me yours.
Okay, wait, sir. Hello, sir. Can you see my sir?
No, not yet. Not yet. Okay. A young lady in the classroom. Okay. Look at mine. Hello, come here. Sini. Look at mine, ya. Mana share screen tadi? Gimana cara share? Ini?
Pending.
Mau habis barangkali. Ini jam 12. Hari suaranya sampai jam 12. Oh, ada.
Tapi itu berkedip nyangka mukanya.
Ini mungkin ceritanya keluar, sir.
Ini sernya banyak buka aplikasi, sir. Jadi agak macet ya. Ya, nah, sudah. Munculkan dulu, Pak, besar, ya. Itu Pak.
Ah, itulah. Can you show me? Can you see this? Bisa lihat?
Not yet, sir. Gelap, sir. Masih dark.
Not yet, sir.
Still loading. Your share screen. Still loading. Memang kayak gitu kalau share screen agak macet, sir. Masih gitu.
So there are three sets ya, ada tiga bulan ya, ada irisan di sini ya, ada irisan. Jadi ladynya di tengah-tengah ya, yangnya itu di set ini mengiris dia. Intersection, ya, yeah. Dia mengiris ke himpunan lady, kemudian in the classroom mengiris pula dia intersection lagi ke apa namanya itu, ke what is it, lady, ini salah ini salah, ini harusnya ke sini, nak. ini harus ada di sini nih, letaknya nih, di dalam ready nih. Kayaknya seperti itu ya. Tapi sudah betul ya, sudah betul ya. Sudah betul.
Jadi bergabung kan ya, apa? Yang ini bergabung sama Lady. Hmm. Lady ini bergabung sama
ya, benar, kan? Sudah betul ya, right. Sudah, have you got it? Belum ya?
Yes,
Have you seen it?
Yes, sir.
Ah, ya. Nah, itu. Jadi Lady in the classroom. Ya. Yeah. So in the classroom is post modifier. A young is pre modifier. Jadi the whole set ya, yeah, himpunan besarnya a young lady in the classroom. Biasanya himpunan besarnya dibuatnya dalam kotak ya. Cara membuatnya itu. Ya. Jadi subset. Okay. Saya kira begini bunyi bentuknya. Jadi lady tidak, dia harus berdiri sendiri, dia simpunan tersendiri. Oke. Okay. Nah, yang jangan dimasuk dengan lady, tapi dia sebelah himpunannya, karena dia tidak ada sangkut pautnya dengan in the classroom. Dia pisah lingkup ini, different set. But the whole, nah itu. Can you do this? Ini yang sederhana, very very simple ya, a young. Bagaimana a very young kan kata sifat. Himpunan lagi sebenarnya nantinya. Ya, subset lagi dia. Tapi masih di dalam a very young itu masih di dalam satu himpunan. Jadi very young dalam satu ini lagi. Nah, kalau pakai a very young lagi kan. Ya. Ya susah kalau kita pakai ini ya. Takes time. Kalau kita pakai tulisan enak ya, langsung the point, oke. Okay. So, our conclusion is that for chapter 3 is you know how to identify different kinds of phrases and also you know how to form different types of phrases to make yeah to write the formula of different types of phrases, and then you know how to use phrases, yeah, the function of phrases in a clause or in a sentence. Okay, among the types of phrases, probably noun phrase is a complex one, because noun phrase yeah may have pre-modifier and post-modifier. Post-modifier can be in the form of prepositional phrase, can be in the form of noun phrase, can be in the form of adjective clause. Yeah, belum itu lebih sedap. Yeah. Because of the time, so this is the end of our meeting today, and I hope next week we will have a quiz, yeah. And make sure you have to do any exercises in chapter 2, 3, and 4. Okay. So hopefully the following weeks we will discuss in detail. Yeah, we apply. Grammatical structure, grammatical category of any phrase or any clause in any sentence. Thank you very much for your attention. Okay. And see you next week.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, I'm leaving, okay? Thank you.